I so sincerely welcome each and every one of you here. Not so much in your physical body, but in soul. And I want to thank you for your devotion and your bhakti. There can never be too many chelas. And the path will unfold and reach out as more here, as the stories start to spread about what the path can do for one. I welcome each and every one that does come, and in particularly yourself. Please drink deeply this weekend. Most of you are already spiritually inebriated, I realize this. But we have to go higher. And it brings up an interesting point. If you're indulging in anything but the truth, more does not mean better. Liquor, drugs, women, men, whatever it may be, money, notoriety. But with the Shabda, that's the only one vibration you can chug, you can drink to your heart's content, and you get higher. And then it's time to get higher. And you have to get higher. And it's almost a subconscious urge to get high on something, a new attachment, some foreign substance. And the way the divine has set it up, it's only the sound that you can drink that freely without the ramifications of the lower worlds, without the ramifications of effect, which is so bittersweet. There's many of you that are laying eyes on me for the first time. There's many of you that have never seen me before, but have seen the inner master. That's the way it's supposed to go. I want to welcome you, the new people. I don't mean to be presumptuous or vain at all, but in all humility, as you get to know the inner master, as you get to know the outer master, whatever difficulties you may have as you perceive him, just start to evaporate and leave you. His strength, his authority, you're able to see it for what it is. Maybe how the master looks or dresses isn't exactly what you had in mind, but in time, you're able to get above the attire of the master. How he talks and teaches you. Eventually you come to see the wisdom and just the unparalleled love that he has for you. All these things take a little bit of time. So please, for the new people, be patient. I will not hold you forever. Only long enough to get you into your true beingness, your true mastership, the rendezvous with the inner form. But I welcome you deeply. But loved ones, you have to understand that sound is endless. There's no beginning, there's no end. What that means then is that the path is endless as well. It means you're endless as well. There's much to do in this path of sound. And as you as an individual get on the path and start unfolding, each in their own way realizes the path has much more magnitude and scope than ever previously envisioned. It's wonderful, no doubt, and it's scary, no doubt. Probably as we're moving through the first couple years, fear is our greatest enemy. Fear of what? Fear of the unknown. Our mind feels itself to be secure, a false security nonetheless, but nevertheless, it feels secure. And as these little anchor points are taken away, lovingly taken away, we become a little unsteady, a little unsettled. We don't have that anchor point. It could be anything, an attitude, a place to go, someone to love. And as we start to purify ourselves, some of these things are exposed for the delusion that they really are. And the mind starts to feel a little trepidatious. It now has nothing to cling on. There's no anchor to hold it steady. And loved ones, the whole idea of being steady when you're unenlightened is an illusion. It's impossible. And that's why your life goes up and down like it is. But the mind's a great rationalizer, and it feels it is steady. And so as you start to come into a greater balance spiritually, the mind feels it, so it's losing its anchor points. So it's actually a big cosmic joke that the mind foists upon your attention. Sometimes in the beginning, we go for that, and we're unable to discriminate properly. And this fear and the worlds of the unknown get the best of us. We wonder if the master will come in and cover the slack. We wonder what we will do without our attachment. Certain attitudes and rationalizations that we had to hide and protect ourselves, legitimately so. When they're gone, sometimes we can feel denuded. Please, loved ones, this is the greatest success you could ever go through, because it's a precursor to moving into a greater state of spirituality. As I said, no divine elixir can go in the glass until some of the old water has been poured out. And this old water being poured out is just these concepts, these outdated mental concepts being removed from you. The Shabda wishes to come in and fill up that partially empty glass. And that's the process you're going through. So please have faith. Have patience. This is a good sign. This being out on the limb that Shirley MacLaine coined, the phrase she coined, is so true. And in fact, it even goes beyond that. You'll crawl out onto the limb and the limb will break. The master will be there to catch you, to guide you aright. Of course, your mind doesn't know this, and you will have to learn that. So some of you that are experiencing this, rejoice. Now, the mind is very powerful, and it's the weaver of illusions. And we've been dancing to this spell for a long time. Profundity is simplicity. Simplicity is profound. Keep it simple. Take refuge in the one that is to redeem and save you. That's all you need remember in times of trouble.